Are they going to tell us when to go, yeah? You're watching CGTN live streaming. I'm Jenny Cortez Ibanez, and we're at the Tianjin Binhai Library in Tianjin, which is northeast of China, for those of you who don't know. So why are we here? Well, basically, it's made a lot of noise in the social media world, and it's caught global attention. So we're here to find out what all the fuss is about. Currently, we're at the main entrance, one of the main entrances, and behind me, you can see the main feature of this library. It's the ball of Binhai's ball, and we are actually going to meet one of the designers, Mr. Chen Tianze, and he's the vice chief architect of Tianjin Architecture Design Institute. Hello, sir.
Hi.
You're right. And we are also with my colleague Meng Jin. Unfortunately, I can't speak Chinese, so we have a translator, one of my colleagues. So let's ask him first, what was the reason behind this project, and what is the concept? What was the concept?
Okay.
就是您最开始这个建筑它的概念，它背后的概念和这个建成这么美丽的建筑，它原因是来自哪儿？这个图书馆？对，还有这个概念，对。是这样，我先简要说一下这个项目的一个情况呀。这个项目呢是从2014年10月25号的时候开始进行的设计，然后呢是在2017年10月1号顺利开馆。它本身的这个图书馆是整个滨海文化中心的一部分，滨海文化中心呢是由几大场馆，有图书馆、美术馆。
So basically, they only built this in a record-breaking 3 years' time. They initiated the idea from 2014. And this library is part of the Binhai Cultural Center. We have the galleries, you know, you saw that, the galleries and the libraries and the performance center. This is just part of the whole creature.
这个项目呢，也是就是滨海新区的这个区委区政府呀搭建的一个所谓一个民生工程。从设计这块呢，是由天津市建筑设计院进行的设计的总负责。一共呢是近50家的设计单位组成的1000人的设计团队共同来完成的这个滨海文化中心这个项目。图书馆呢是其中的一部分。
Okay, they have a total team of 1,000 architects and the whole team to build this cultural center. And this is just part of the cultural center as we know. And most of the parts are done by the Tianjin Urban Design Institute.
And they worked together with the MVRDV, a company based in Holland. How did you go about creating each space? So, yes.
您这个每个空间当时设计的是怎么构想的？每个部分怎么去？是这样，图书馆呢，基本上它是分为三大部分。首先呢，咱们所在的这个位置，这是图书馆的中央大厅。中央大厅这个呢，也是基本上是比较大型的公共建筑，它的人员的一些疏散呀，还有是做一些其他的活动这么一个场地。这是第一部分。我说完了。
Okay. So the first part is what we saw the eye of Binhai. It's also called the living room of Binhai, the living room, the guest room, you know, and where you can see, welcome room. It's like a very open area. People can take selfie, take photos here, and even chat like us.
Yeah, that's good. It's so informal. It's so informal. Yeah, unique. 这是一部分。然后在它的后部两侧这块是阅览空间，阅览空间呢会占到图书馆的绝大部分的面积。在里边看书、读报，啊，这是第二部分。第三部分呢，在这个地下还有一个书库。 书库呢，藏书量是120万册，基本上是由这三大部分组成。那他们还可以去到地下？他们不行，内部的工作人员。对。Okay,
wow, cool. So the second part in the majority is a reading room. Reading rooms, 1,200 seats here, and another part, a kind of secret part, is underground. That's actually a storage for the books. We couldn't walk in as readers, but staff can walk underground. That's where those books lie in.
Right, so there's a total of 6 levels. This is how big. It's 33,700 square meters big, and currently houses around 233,000 books, if I'm not mistaken. So I've you know, noticed in some of the areas, it's not got actual books. It's more of a material design. May I ask why they chose to do this?
Okay, this is很有特色的，就是这个书墙。The
camera, if you can have a look, the camera behind, just in between the steps. Not actual real books, but more of design of books.
一个是从设计这方面要讲，再有一个呢，也是从咱们这个规范这方面要讲一下。本身的图书馆这是需要一个中央的一个，就是说活动以及疏散的一个大厅的，这可能是必须的。再有呢，就是说这个大厅从消防的定义上，它是一个亚安全区，叫亚安全区。然后呢，这个亚安全区呢是为了大量的人流，如果是着火的时候要紧急疏散出去的，所以这个区域呢是不能放易燃物的。 所以是不能放书的，但是图书馆这块呢，它作为一个比较大型的一个公建筑，肯定是需要一个大厅的。但是设计之初呢，我们也想不想把这大厅做成一个光秃秃的，就是四面非常直上直下的一个大厅，也想呢融入一些这种文化特色、图书的元素。所以呢，就做这种造型。另外呢，就是这上面你们看到这个假书上面实际上还有一些这种微穿孔，对吧？有一些微穿孔，细心的这个读者可以看到。 这些微穿孔呢，就是说我们当时对这大厅的内部的声学环境也进行了计算机的模拟，可以感觉到在这儿没有那种非常超大空间拢音那种效果，对吧？回声，然后听不清楚讲话，没有那种效果，就是得益于此。
Okay, please summarize for. Sorry, I wish I could speak Chinese.
I can't remember most of them. So basically, there are two reasons behind. One reason is for the designing. They want to make it like a book culture thing, because this is just as a like if it's like a hotel, it's just the lobby part, right? Like a hall. So, and the second part is for the safety concern. Actually, this part is kind of easy to get fired for the firefighting things. Okay. So you couldn't put these like books, which are easily get burned if there's a fire, you know, that's what
fire hazard then.
Yeah, fire hazard. So it's a safety concern for the second reason. And if you watch this carefully, you will see there are some small holes in each of the wall.
Do you know if our CGTN audience and viewers can see there's holes in the, is it steel? Is it made out of steel?
Or?
Metal, okay. The reason for that is
to minimize the echoes, you know, for the voice. You know when I say it too loud, maybe it echoes from the top.
Reduce echoing in the room.
Yeah, reduce echoing.
And actually, that was something that a lot of people wondered around the world. So hopefully, we've answered that question for you. Any further developments or future plans to maybe extend or do more in the library or in the surrounding areas?
有没有一些未来的规划，就是会扩张，看那么火，或者是说有一些其他周边建设？那个是这样，就是。
实际上，大家看到的这个图书馆只是这个整体30万平米的滨海文化中心的一部分。这个文化中心呢，首先10月1号是一个试开馆，图书馆开了，然后旁边呢，实际上还有规划探索馆、市民活动中心那些场馆呢也是非常非常精彩的，就是不亚于图书馆。都是你们设计的。对，我们天津市建筑院是一个设计的一个总负责，是由我们院的有一个国家设计大师刘景良刘大师。 来牵头的牵人的设计团队来共同完成的这个滨海文化中心，而且呢，就是大家也看到这个外面还有一个滨海文化公园也正在建设，正在建设。Okay,
so do you want to summarize?
都是会陆续展现的。So,
Mr. Chen highly recommends the whole culture center, not only the library, because you know there are other parts like galleries and even the park outside. They're in construction right now, so they will be maybe even more beautiful than the library than what we expect here. So that's more we can expect in the future.
Great. A couple more questions just about disability access for those who are maybe disabled or visually impaired. Do they think of those?
残疾人，你们是有什么考虑？残疾人是这样，老人这块呢，在一楼有一个老人的阅览室，它的内部的空间呢，无论从照度上，还是说从家具的使用上，另外呢，还有一些软包上，都做了比较亲近老年人的一些使用。第二呢，就是说残障人士这块。 对一些坐轮椅来的这些人士呢，我们都是将它的这个第一，就是说可以非常方便的到达阅览区，因为有无障碍的电梯，无障碍电梯可以非常方便的到达。第二呢，为他们提供的书架呢都是比较低矮的，可以方便坐在轮椅上购这个图书。
For the elderly and disabled people, they have special areas we will show you later in this video, in this live. And they actually create a cozy place for these special groups of people, like very low-level shelves and also very easily approachable books.Things like that.
Great.
那个我还想再说一下，除了这些人士呢，为视障人士实际上也提供了一个特殊的一个阅览室。
For visually impaired people and blind people, they also created a certain area for them.
让每位市民在这儿都能有一个。
And finally, final question. In your opinion, why do you think the design aspect has become so popular, the aesthetics of it, globally?
Okay, 那个就是最后一个问题，就是您觉得为什么它会这么那个火，特别是在全火到全球去？您之前有想到为什么会这样？
这个之前没有想过。这个当时我们做设计的时候，本身从建筑师角度来说呢，可能更好的解决它的功能性，而且呢，如何为市民这块营造一出场所感，是吧？包括它的空间，可能能做的是不是有意思一些？而且除了风格上，还有它的形式上、功能上，都能满足人的使用，那个使用的要求。这个可能是建筑师追求的一个目标吧。而且我也觉得呢，可能一个好的建筑呀，就是不单单是让人能记住它的样子，同时呢，应该是这个人，这个建筑为人提供了怎样一种空间，而且让人呢能记住在里边这种活动、这种感受、这种心情，这个才是最重要的。
Okay. He never expected would be so popular, and because he wanted to just make it like a library function thing, and providing the best service they can for readers. That's their final pursuit. So I think they didn't expect the popularity.
Oh well, thank you very much. And I know we got a lot. You have a lot of media requests, but you granted our permission. So thank you so much for your time. Don't go away. We'll be interviewing later here. Yeah. And you can watch more of our interview on the CGTN channel. Thank you, Shashani. Thank you. And now we're going to follow us around. We're going to do a tour for you guys at CGTN. And I'm still joined by Meng Jun. And we have our tour guide here, Chao Zhou. Chao Zhou. Hi, how are you?
Hello. Hello. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. So take us around.
Yeah.
So follow us. I have my... translator with me still, as Chinese, learning Chinese is definitely in my books this year, but yeah, slowly but surely. Yes, read more here. And at this point, we're just about to enter one of two children's reading areas. So take a look at the very colorful children's reading room. Have a look. Tan, our cameraman Tan. So tell us a little bit about this room.
This is for infants, babies and children, basically from 0 to 6 years old. They can read there with their parents. Look.
然后我们现在这个墙架上的这些书呢，全部都是国内外一些知名的一些绘本。
And these animation books are actually from domestically and overseas. Maybe Jenny, you will find some you have been reading in London.
Yes. Actually, what's really...
worldwide.
Yeah, interesting. Actually, I'm not very surprised, is that children here start learning and reading very early on. And I think that's a great, great thing. Yeah, some learning. This is definitely something I'd love.
You can take your children.
Exactly. Why not here at the Tianjin Library? Even the toilets, I mean, I don't know if you want to look. They have children's designs on them, which I find so cute. It's very busy at the moment, so apologies with all the crowds around.
For babies,
special. Oh, a special room. Okay, yeah. So we have a family room. A very nice family-friendly room. Sweet, yeah. We call it. So yeah, they really thought about all the things that families and local people and tourists alike need. Are we moving into this room? So this is the second children's reading room.
For older children.
For older children. What age?
Still for infants and babies and children.
And here it's more crowded, lots of children looking through books, more fun, obviously very family and child friendly. They've got some screens over there, loads of books, obviously very colourful to make it attractive for children. So how many families do we know or children come and use these rooms?
现在成立到现在有多少家庭或孩子来过有大概的一个
我们现在就是说每到周末的时候这个房间的累计的这个人流量在4000到5000人
是每天吗
每天
Wow, cool
每个周末的天
So every weekend for each day they got like 4,000 or 5,000 people in this room for
Just this room?
Just this room
Wow
And the other children's room, okay. 4,000, 5,000 per day.
Per day.
Yeah.
Wow.
Families.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so you do the math, how many per year? don't have time for that. But yeah, it's lovely. It's great. Loads of people here at the moment. Let's move on to the next part of the library. Very interactive. Lots of, as you can imagine, lots of screens where children can play and read on screens. And at this point, we are in a reception area.
Yeah, we can search books here, and there's a area.
这个大屏呢，它会实时显示出我们每一个馆区不同时间的一个借阅统计量。就是说借书还书的次数在这个大屏上都显示出来，包括哪些图书比较受读者欢迎的借阅排行榜都在这个大屏上实时显示。
Okay. This is an up-to-date screen for how many books people are borrowing and returning. And you have a look. You see, and the, you know, on the left is a ranking for those books which are so popular, top six, you know. And they're changing all the time, up to date. And also, this screen in the middle shows you how many books they're borrowing and returning for each, actually for each libraries in Binhai new areas.
Four libraries.
Yes.
And this is the latest one, I presume.
Latest
one. Yeah, yeah. So all very much real-time information, is that correct?
Yeah.
Wow, okay. QR code, of course, here in China. Mm-hmm. Much needed way of life here, QR codes. So now we are.
This is not.
自助借还自助的办证机还自助的借还书机
Areas, you can see automatic card issue.
So you need an ID card, though.
I have it.
Yeah. So okay, let's
don't
try
it.
don't show the details on it. But Meng Zhen is ID. Okay. So do you choose your book first?
No.
Okay.
My information.
No details. No photos.
Okay, fine. Okay, my number.
What's happening?
This is my this part, but this is actually my number here.
Yes.
So I will become a reader now. Now, so I can borrow books within.
Oh, so you've signed up basically.
Signed up,
registered. You're on the system, and you are taking books from the library.
It's within 10.
What? Okay, and now we are
self-checking out machine. Can check out and check in.
You don't need my translation.
You can take.
Okay,
so she's just gonna show us how to
check out.
Yeah.
Okay, let's borrow a book.
And ID card.
So this is books I want to borrow.
Okay.
The two.
It's two books.
The two books, yeah. Oh, yeah, the two. They
yes.
were. Wow, so quick.
It's okay. You can bring.
Gives you the details.
Yes.
Okay, great.
And that's it.
That's it.
Brilliant. Great. And obviously, I'm sure there's still people around and that can help you if you have any questions. But everything, obviously, here is machine orientated. Yeah, very digital, very modern way of doing it. Okay, let's move on to the next part. Which area is next?
See the old man. And
the book.
Yes.
for the elderly.
Okay, so
disabled people.
What's great about this library is they really thought about everyone that could to the space, and so right now seeing some of the areas where the are able to go, and those who might need the extra support. And at this point, we're back at the main, if you like, lobby of your home. And it's a bit behind us, as you can see, it's the ball, the eye, the eyeball of this library, and behind, and actually in both sides, are the what they're called book really, and it's I'm just cameraman, please be careful.
This space here.
It's called Shushan, the Book Mountain. I don't know whether the translation is good or Shushan.
Totally in this library now they have, you know, 230,000 books now.
如果说数字的话, 我们现在目前有15TB, 它是一个按这个储存量,
okay. 15TB for the digital. Okay. This is storage.
Right.
Yeah.
And the elderly space for the elderly, what have they done?
Let's walk this way.
Okay, we're walking this way.
Pretty big. Watch out.
Mind your step. So yes, it's open all year round, apart from Monday mornings. And the mission.
You know, missions for
the library.
然后能做我们的那个高端的一些服务和专线化的一些服务。
Problem with the mic. So, can you turn the shoe?
Problem with the mic. 没事，我交手机吧。
You're still watching CGTN live streaming. I'm Jenny Cortez Ibanez, and we are still here at the Tianjin Binhai Library. Apologies for the technical difficulties that we've just had, but we're back, and hopefully you're still with us. So we were just discussing with our tour guide here, Chiao Zhou, about the room that they had available for visually impaired people, and my colleague here who's translating as well for me. Unfortunately, I can't speak Chinese, and we're going to move on to the next room that's special about this library. Let's go ahead. And this is a room actually for the elderly. So the elderly also have their own special room, and we're going to find out why and how it's a good use for them. So why is, what's great about this room?
它是这个结构也是不一样的，包括这个阅览椅的这个样子。这个房间呢，我们是精挑细选，适合老年人的报纸和杂志。然后有90多种报纸，有100多种这个杂志。然后包括它的这个阅览坐席，这个桌子的弧度角度也是适合阅报的那种角度去看的阅读角度。
So this is so good for elderly people. You can read hundreds of magazines and newspapers here. You can see the Xinhua. Maybe so old people.
Let's do a close up over here, Mr. Cameraman.
This one.
This way?
Yeah, this way. Okay. So, suppose I'm an old man, so I read it like this. So, this angle is very good for elderly people to read, right? This angle.
It's easier and clearer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
And for their maybe neck, you know.
Posture.
Yeah, posture. Yeah.
Great. Awesome. So, yeah, another awesome room. Let's move straight to the next part of the library. Again, it's 33,700 square meters big. And we've been going and touring around. Earlier, we spoke to one of the designers that helped build and create and design this masterpiece. We're back here at another room for the visually impaired, which is great. I think it's a brilliant idea, and I feel that every library should have this type of room. So let's move back to what we're doing here.
This is actually for the visually impaired people.
That's it.
So I think Xiao Zhe can show us how to use this.
Yes. Here we go.
这是一个放大的设备，我们可以就是说本身它这个书就是大字版图书，但是有的那个视弱的人他会看不清，那我们就可以把这本书放在这里。
So you see, we can zoom in for this visually impaired people. They can see, change the color of the characters, better for their eyes, protect their sight.
Yeah, great. Awesome. So everything here, especially for them. So what a great concept, what a great idea. Let's move back to the main area, main living room. And we're going to close this very soon, but we have to speak to some of the users to see what they like best about this amazing library. It's known as, well, lots of people have said it's the coolest library. It's been branded most beautiful library in China by many, and also it's described as the ocean of books, and hopefully you get to see why that is. But I'm sure if you do get the chance to visit it, it's definitely different when you get to experience it firsthand. And again, you can hopefully reminder. Oh, okay, we've got some users who are willing to speak to us. Obviously, we need to translate. So, okay, so to us, great. Yeah. So, please, why do they come here? What's great about this library?
Okay. 是第一次来吗？为什么要来这边？哦，是的。然后为什么来这儿？是因为看见这块儿就是新开的嘛，然后就是挺吸引人的。是当地的人？嗯，不是当地的。是从哪儿来的？哦，东北。哦，从东北过来天津。哦，不是，是一直在这边待着。
生活。哦。
然后
听说这边有一个就是新开一个博物馆，挺吸引人的。
体验怎么样啊？
还好，我俩刚进来，刚转了一圈。
喜欢这个感觉吗？
喜欢。
Okay, the first time come here. Actually, they're not the local here, but they heard about it.
Oh, wow, so, where are they from? Far from here?
Yeah, they actually live in Tianjin, but they're from the northeastern part of China.
Nice, okay.
Yeah, so they really enjoy the experience here. 那你们在这边看书还是现在拍照？
哦，就先看看大概都有什么样的嘛，然后就是想拍两张照留念一下。
They want to take more photos here.
Okay, and what's been the best part of the library for them? What they enjoyed the most?
那你们转了一圈，觉得哪部分是最吸引你们的？现在，最喜欢的，
可能是这个设计吧，就是整体一进来就特别吸引人，不像就是平时那种普通的图书馆，然后就是挺普通的，只是一层一层，这个就是整个那种造型就比较吸引人。
Of course, it's the designing, the first impression they have left. So, it's unlike the ordinary libraries, floor by floor, but this one is so unique.
Great. Thank you so much for your time and enjoy it. I'm sure this is not the first and last time they're going to come. So, Shashani, thank you very much. Let's see if we can grab some more people before we end. But just want to say a massive, massive thank you before we close to the local government and the staff here at the library for giving us the opportunity. And Xiao Zhou, of course, and the designer earlier, Mr. Chen Tianzi. Thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to tour around and get to know this place.More.
Can we go to the
let's go back up. Let's see if we've got time.
Yeah, I think we've got
But if not, don't worry.
Watch out.
Mind your step as well.
Mind the steps.
Mind the step. Yeah. This is.
小心
Careful.
Yep. And well, you definitely will not miss the mind the step signs in bright red. Don't know if you can see. But yeah, it's all.The shelves are all in white, which makes it look very clean and very modern. I don't know if you can see the view from outside over there, but it's absolutely stunning. I don't know if we'll have time later, but of the outside of this building, you will be able to see the design of an actual eye, and the eyeball is inside the main welcome room, as we figured. And also outside, it actually, you know, driving here looked like a building site. As we mentioned earlier, and as the designer mentioned earlier, this is part of a larger project to create a cultural center, and it's one out of five center attractions here at the Binhai Cultural Center. And they've got lots of other buildings, performing centers, and now we have a user, we have a male user.
Can speak English. Yeah.
Yes, you can speak English, great. Makes it easier for me. So, is this your first time here in this library?
Yes.
Yeah, so what made you come and visit this specific library? What made you come here?
I drive the car.
You drove the car? Okay.
You wanna? Now he talked with me that he saw his friends shared a post in the WeChat. That's why he came here to have a look.
Yeah. And what's been the best part? What have you enjoyed the most here?
Which part you like most?
I like art.
Oh, sorry?
You can say in Chinese. You can translate.
就是文学艺术这一块。
啊，你就设计什么呢？就是你最喜欢这个图书馆的哪一部分？
哪一部分是吧？
就是
设计，然后是挺有风格的。
书呢？
书的话，比较喜欢文学这一块的。
很多是吧？这边挺多的文学。
啊，对，挺多的。然后这个历史。
Just now we talked about this book has a large collection of history books and literature. That's actually what his interest lies in. So this library really is his cup of tea.
Oh, brilliant. Thank you very much. Enjoy Shashani. Thank you. Thank you so much again. And we want to say a massive thank you to the local government. I know they get a lot of media requests and they were able to grant our one. So thank you very much. It's been fantastic. Hope you've enjoyed your tour. Thank you to our lovely tour guide and my translator. and the designer earlier, but for now it's a goodbye. And don't forget to like and comment on all of our posts. We're available on the CGTN app, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Weibo, of course. Until next time, I'm Jenny Cortez Ibanez, reporting for CGTN Tianjin, China. Bye.